No, it's going well. Thoroughly enjoying it.
This first vault's crucial on Beckford's
we go. A really important stage of the competition with the vaults.
Powerful vault to look for. Well, he'd be looking forward to vault final. He was fourth in 06 there, so it's a strong piece for him. And could set a marker for the second half of the competition for him. I'm going to keep my eyes on him.
Reiss Beckford of England has established a small lead in the all-around competition. Must nail this vault. He's first to go in the fourth rotation. Can he keep his lead? Can he extend it?
Nice, easy stride. Yeah, 1.5 turns in the Yachenko. Good, solid vaulting. Extra half twist is worth 0.4 on his difficulty, so he's got a 5.8 start value. Back flip on, good punch up, 1.5 turns, just the pace back, but this is solid all-round consistency, which is what Beckford will be looking for. Look at that beautiful style, high off the top, 1.5 turns.
15-2 in qualifying. Came in with a 0.1 lead. Beckford.
Ashish Kumar from India.
On parallel bars, Ashish Kumar. His spectacular vault gave him something to work with here, Mitch.
Yes, but there's always there's technical holes in this. He needs to rescue it with a... Yes, that's very difficult work. He's really going for it. He's relying on difficulty. Technically, he's not brilliant, but there's a big heart there. That cuts. It's be a long swing through the bar. Oh, what a pity. And he sat down on the tip out, and that will be hugely expensive. So, he's got so much there. Huge heart, great difficulty, but that little sit down in the middle will cost him dearly.
That's what we've loved about the Indian gymnasts. They absolutely go for their stuff.
Yeah, double front there, look. Lots of difficult work. There's the double pike. They're all using it. Little scurry back.
Now, Josh Jefferis needs a big vault. Started to make his move on rings. Got to maintain that momentum here.
Look at that run. So much power. Nicely done. One and a half turns in the straight front somersault from handspring. Look at that run. He means business. Big push from the top of the horse. Smacks the twist in. Let's have a look to see if he kept it square. He doesn't want to put the foot in the red zone. It'll be a tenth. If he lands in it, it'll be more. And that's just a tenth. And then you've got the alignment problem.
So Jefferis. A 15.25. That's a good vault from him. 15.4 though in qualifying, so just not quite what he was after. And over to high bar.
Good start. Impressed with this young man in qualifying. Full twist across the top of the bar. Almost lost the swing there, but rescued it well. Forward circle, that's such a risky move to put in. It's not high value, but it really needs excellent timing. Did it again. Half turn there, winding up now. Here comes the dismount. And it's a triple, and he stood it up. Well done. He's so delighted. A triple back somersault. Lovely to see it. Look, selecting the shapes very carefully. Mile up in the air, three rotations, and he will be delighted.
A 20-year-old yes. Northern Irishman. Yeah, out. Surprised he's got anything left. Back to the vault and Thomas Pichler.
Measured stride. Oh, yes. Double twist from the Ochenko approach. So they round off onto the board, backflip off the horse, and then twist in the air. Here comes the round off. There's the backflip. Yep, double twist. Again, he hopped to the side. We'll have to have a view of that. Very difficult to twist and stay centre. Good contact. There's the double twist. Landed in the middle. Oh, and he kept it in. Well done.
Yes, from side on. Looked like he might have contacted the red area. He did not. So a 15.3 for Thomas Pichler. That helps lift him up a few places. Really interesting in the vault warm-up, watching the English and Australian coaches working in concert to get everything ready. 12-7 for Kumar on P-bars, but teamwork even amongst the coaches.
Oh, yeah.
It's really heartening to see.
Yeah, it's fabulous stuff. He made the point. It is the Commonwealth, it is a family, and it is the spirit of sport.
There's often this kind of cold-hearted professionalism about sport these days, but here you're seeing know, the better side of it in many ways. Robert Honeyball, I have to say, he's one of my favourite gymnasts here. He's got such a story to tell.
Oh, very long. Put the foot out at the end. But a good start, full twisting double. A lot of the gymnasts using the double twist, which used to be such a big move, I'll go back 20 years. But now they're using it just as a fill. Oh, staggered sideways, but got it under control. A little bit of a double touch there on the lift, and he didn't hold the handstand. A little bit nervous out there. But he is four routines in now. To have to include a single leg balance, not so these days on the new judging code. Very useful for a breather though. Oh, and it did look low, but he did get it round. Double tuck.
Well, it's his second all-around performance from Melbourne 4 years ago. I wonder how long he'll keep performing with an 11-month-old baby back home, and the demands biomedical engineers. Got a lot of the bases covered. Maybe it's time to move on from gymnastics. It's wonderful to see him here.
And still in good shape by the look of it.
And for Beckford, 15.05 on vault. Should be good enough to keep him in front. Might be one of his England teammates who will be the closest challenger through this rotation. Carson on high bar at 12.75. He's loving it out there.
He's had a great competition. Surprised himself, I think, in the qualifying.
Back to the vault on young Max Whitlock.
Good light run. Zips it round, but he's way to the side.
Yes, he got way offline. That will cost him.
My guess is he cast to the side when he made contact on the platform. Make the double twist. But yeah, he obviously started to twist when he was on the platform. We'll see now. He's probably veering over to the right, and you can see it well over. And he carried on in that direction. Both feet out, that'll be quite a big deduction. 3-5.
And a 14.65 for Max Whitlock. 8.95 for execution. And,
nothing wrong in the air, but that landing would have cost him.
And for Honeyball, 11.75. The man from right. Namibia. He was 17th all around in Melbourne. Luke Folwell. This is a pretty important moment for him, Mitch, as he looks to challenge Beckford.
Well, normally he'd be delighted to get to this stage in the competition, the position he was, because this is his best apparatus. But we've seen it before. He can buckle under pressure, but I would be very surprised if he didn't produce a good, solid vault.
Last man up on vault. Luke Folwell.
Runs really strongly. There's the double front, and he's got it round. That's the Roche handspring double front. Now, it's worth 6.6, that's the difficulty.
Just look where he finished, he's nearly at the end of the matting. It was enormous height and travel.
He did very well to get that round. Rotated, let's have a look at it now. Contact on the horse. He was a little bit long in with his heels, but it was high and it did travel. That big jump forward. But that's a 6-6 difficulty. Look at this. Did he get a big push? Huge push. Squeezes around the double rotation. Deep, but he's around and he's happy. Look.
Very deep landing, but he kept his backside off the mat. That's important.
Well, yeah, when he got a 6-6 value for the vault, you know, you only need 8-4 and you're into the 15s on execution. And that's what he won.
Panagiotis Aristotelous.
Big vaulting from him.
15-6-5 for Luke Folwell. Still Kumar's 16-2 is the high mark today. The adventurous Indian vaulter, that was something too.
And you've just hit the nail on the head. There's always something. Somewhere in this hall, you don't know where it's coming from, there's always something to watch and always something spectacular. They're giving us a great competition.
Aristotelous had a 12.05 on high bar on Monday. And he's just making some final adjustments.
And those adjustments are absolutely crucial. Guards have got to feel comfortable.
Cyprus really emerging in Commonwealth Games gymnastics. First time they've sent a full men's team, first time they've sent any women, and two of them came.
No, I like their work. I think they're well prepared, good techniques. Doing it the right way, get the techniques and then build the difficulty. Not taking too many chances. There's a little turn coming up here at the start. There's made sure of it. Nice full turn, heely turn. And another. Squat dislow has to include that close in bar element. Big release. There's the catch up. It's on, it's swinging. Stalder, just a straddle backwards, a nice turn forward there. Nicely out in the squat dislocate swing. Now he's swinging against the grass, hopping back into normal grasp. The little half turn, the big wind-up swings will come. There they come. Worked hard in the double twisting, double straight, good routine.
Pichler to do a 360 though to greet the judges, almost lost his bearings there. Well done, Aristotelous.
Some really good work. You can see good shape selection to make, set up this. It's a long way round, two twists and a straight somersault.
Now where am I? Oh yes, you're over there. Well done. And back to the vault for Sam Offord.
Very careful, then accelerates. That's a good strong vault, double twist in the Yurchenko. Love the way he measures his approach. Let's see the contact. Square, good conversion upwards, double twist, bang in the center. Just with a pace. Little windmill to make sure of the control.
And a 15-5 for Sam Offord. Very healthy score. 9-3 for the execution. And on the floor, our friend from the Isle of Man, Alex Hedges.
A double Arabian. High, light, easy. And then almost falls over just standing in the corner. That's amazing. But he's tumbling well. Just has to get that position right. That little shove back would have cost him. But he's tumbling so well. There's another pass coming up. Whip over. Side salto. Good landing. And again, that little lurch to the side. Slightly nervous, but he's gone through well. Half turn. Backwards, half turn forwards. Little stag leap to the corner. Right, he's settled down. Final tumble, he got 10 seconds after that buzzer. Didn't need it. Wraps the twist round. That was good work, some good tumbling in that.
Trains of both Huntington and the Manx Club, the Isle of Man.
He's another one, you know, he works really well. He's balancing a career with his gymnastic life. That was good work.
And to be a Cambridge graduate and to be an elite gymnast, what a remarkable achievement. A couple of levels. Aristotelous, high bar, 13.5. It's 0.5 better than his qualifying score, so well done to him. That rotation really gave the top six an opportunity to clear themselves out from the field and settle it down into a competition between them, perhaps. And Hedges on floor, a 13-2 as he heads off to the next rotation. Two rotations to go, and it's Folwell and Beckford this time. They flip positions. Josh Jefferis has made a bit of a move, but he's a full point behind. Then it's Max Whitlock. Misha Koudinov of New Zealand has steamed up to fifth position. And then it's Sam Offord, Thomas Pichler, and Dimitris Krasias of Cyprus. So a fantastic effort to be in the top eight through four. And Kumar has just dropped back a little. And Carson, Watson, Gardiner of Wales. Great competition here.
Have 30 seconds of warm-up.
That's the one final he made. Jefferis.
There's a few medal aspirations in that group. Mm. Two performances still to go. And Beckford. Let's get a little feel for the apparatus. Requirements to get the bars exactly as they want.
Josh Jefferis is ready to start the fifth rotation. He's some 1.5 marks behind the leader, but he's really a master of this apparatus. He's got to make it work for him.
Solid start. Oh, and that was a break in form on the half turn for the elder somersault, but very well recovered there into the somersault from long swing, and just a little bit hesitant there. But that's big. Straddle 1.25, keeps the swing going. Couple of technical errors to start. Big in the tip out. Good Healy. That second Healy to upper arms. He's really working for this. He'll pop off. And a double pike. Well done indeed, because there were some errors earlier on. He could have lost it right at the second move. He did so well to fight that. He's not happy.
No, he knows there were errors here.
And the double pike, though, that was tidy.
But he had a 14.65 in qualifying for P-bars, and I don't think he can match that, those mistakes, and he needed to. Tariq Dowers of Canada on high bar.
Another young team, and they've produced some good individual performances. Yamawaki to get his release requirement over. Nice discipline in the stouter shapes, the straddle shapes. 1.5 turns. Not hugely difficult. A little hop across the bar to get the center of it. Coming off early, good stuff, twisting dismount, so good young team, good technique, well prepared.
Yeah, just 16 years of age and 13-2 there. Across to Thomas Pichler. So what's happened with the previous rotation, Mitch, is that top six seeded gymnasts are in the top seven, so they're really coming cream rising to the top, as we say.
Absolutely. And this was a good start from him. Lovely Healy out of his shoulders, good combination into the straddle front. I like this P-bars. going well. Did he scrape the ground then? I'm not sure, but he's swinging well. Very clean. Now he's producing something more like we expected from him. Double pike off low, though he had to work hard to get it round. Staggered back a little. But now he's preparing for the next gymnast.
Straight away thinking about his teammates. Yeah. That's what it's about.
That technique was superb in the Healy, and the combination into straddle front. This really was a good parallel bars. And there's your double pike that almost brought him to grief.
Using his strength to recover, really, retrieve the dismount. And we'll say it again though, Mitch, looking good for England.
Yeah. You just look at the right-hand side of that screen for their overall score. That's crucial now.
Robert Honeyball there, preparing for pommels. Bit of a delay there, so let's go across to Max Whitlock.
Bent his legs to get through there, but a supine start, quite difficult to stay clean, but he does swing so well. Got a lovely light frame, good Healy technique, full turn forwards, strong uprise, beautifully prepared through the manner, catching all these techniques so well, grounded into him. Good handstand shape, flying back a little bit hurried. There's his double pike out, a little skip forward, but some lovely touches there.
Such an elegant gymnast. When he nails it, it's great to watch.
That's the word, elegance. And that was just a bit hurried, but he kept the swing, flying back, turned to handstand. That's a classic combination. And the double pike, just a tiny little skip forward. He's coming good.
What promise he holds at 17.
Fabulous.
If you can keep him relatively injury-free.
Well, with a frame like that, he shouldn't have too many problems. He needs to bulk up a bit for rings, but he's nice and light. He's not going to have too much stress on joints. He's great shape for the sport.
And here is Robert Honeyball from Namibia. Trains these days in South Africa, Stellenbosch.
Travelling forwards. Magyar Zavada, the two great Hungarians in the mid-70s, put those skills together. I think it's over 30 years old and it's still testing now, and it just on a simple circle in the middle, he comes off. And he's had a good competition, it's a pity for him. You know, a lot of these gymnasts, the target for them, the challenge for them, is to go 6 for 6. Mm. If you do 6 routines, doesn't matter where you're on the leaderboard, that's the target, that's the achievement. Picks up nicely, got some nice little techniques. And opts for the simple dismount.
Well, a shame about the fall for Robert Honeyball. Second time, though, in an all-around final. That's a great credit to him.
He's on the podium, but they're waiting for
the score. Just a little pause in the rhythm of swing there, and hops off early to make sure.
Rings his strongest apparatus. Now, Josh Jefferis, a 14-1-5.
Let's go, Sam.
Needed a bit more than that.
Let's go, Sammy.
And for Pichler, it was a 13-8-5. just starting to show you their totals, 69-15, because the competition is really hotting up. Those, their overall total is what really means the most now as we get towards the end. Sam Offord.
Locks out of the under somersault. Nice bell, a double somersault from long swing to catch. Another long swing. There's the tip out, the back cuts to handstand. Lovely uprise technique, and he just got his legs free of the bars. Oh, lost his legs there on the hop out. Good double pike.
And a 13.75 in qualifying.
Really set that double pike up. He was determined to make that dismount.
The Australian uniforms have drawn a bit of comment. They're kind of a little bit bland, that greyish colour. You've got a view about them, Mitch?
Well, they're not flattering for the body line either. I mean, you need just a little bit of a... A little suntan would help, but it makes them fade into the background. No, I think it's... yeah, there's been general comments. But they can work, they can swing, and they're a good team. Good individuals.
All gymnasts spend so much time indoors, I don't think that many of them are going to have a tan.
No.
Well, this is a big routine for Misha Koudinov. He's got himself in contention.
Well, I like this gymnast. He is another one. He's been all round prepared. Good basic, solid technique. Good, clear, high Yamawaki to make the release. Here's another release. Good in the catch. Plenty of rotation, plenty of swing. Now then. That's lovely, easy, lollops round in the full turn, catches it easy. Now he's swinging in twists of grass, now he's out to regular. Here comes the wind-up. Chucks a triple, adjusts the pace forward. Good work.
Oh, Misha Koudinov for 13-4. He's a chance for a medal for New Zealand. Sitting in fifth at the moment. A few more athletes to come in this fifth rotation. Can't ride him in too early. Luke Folwell, challenging for gold.
Interesting to see that after that superb vault, he just didn't let himself celebrate. He's trying to stay focused. Good technique in the under somersault. Locks out in the long swing. This is big. Clean. Look at it. Sharp. Holds the half lever. Solid in the handstand. Now then, Mr. Folwell. Slightly off center there, but pulled the swing back. Those handstands are so crucial. Good on the heely. Oh, and he just lost the swing there. And another little dip. So he needed two swings to settle down, making sure this is important for him. And rescues it on the double pike. Just a few minor faults in there.
I wouldn't have tipped that excellent dismount after his two earlier problems. He's done a tremendous job there.
Absolutely focused. Couple of little dips in handstands. We'll have a look, I'm sure.
We better get across to the high bar because the crowd here at the Indira Gandhi Stadium is going off. Their man is here, Ashish Kumar.
He's got some incredibly difficult work and he needs to get it under control. First release coming up. He's on. Well done, and you can hear their reaction. Here's the second release. He's on again, that time of the half turn. Well, come on, boy. This is the stuff. No wonder they're buzzing in the crowd. Made the full turn. They're in raptures now. Now then. Full turn. He'll be changing the shape. He's hopped across to the middle of the bar. He's put it all in there. He's run it off. Oh, and he's run out of steam. What a pity. He's not done yet. Big wind-up. Oh, he's all over the show. He almost ran out of mat. That's the longest dismount I've ever seen in my life. So he's broken the world long jump record, and that was sheer gumption.
Well, it was great to see him, and as is his smile and the crowd. Well, no matter what they know about gymnastics, they know they love their man. Kumar is an entertainer.
Oh, well, that was terrific to watch.
Oh, let's get back to the top of the table, though, which is where Reiss Beckford's been from the get-go.
Good, clean start. Solid in that handstand. This is important. Locks out in the undersummy. Just the pace forward. Back cuts to handstand. It's so clean so far. Healy hits it. Diaminov hit that as well. Full turn forwards and backwards. Steady swing. Sets up the underswing. Back cuts. This is very clean, very economical. Here comes your dismount. Oh, and he's fallen over right at the last gasp there. So that's going to cost him. It could be a whole mark. Or did he scrabble and 5 or 8 tenths? Let's have a look. But this was lovely. Hit the Diaminov. Hit the swinging turndown set. So until the dismount, let's have a look. What did he get down? Did this? Yes, the seat touched. He's going to lose a mark.
Oh, that's such a shame. It looks so good. He had that power and elegance going until the end.
That's
Max
good.
Whitlock, 70.6, 14.5 on parallel bars. Oh, but for Beckford, is that his chance at the all-around title? Slipping through his fingers. He seemed to over-rotate on that dismount.
Well, he did. He worked very hard for it. It was going through so clean, all the work on the valve so clean, and he just thought, let's just give this a squeeze and get it round. Just overdid it.
He might have handed it to his teammate, Folwell, 72.3, and I think he's going to be your leader as we go into the last rotation. And he will take some catching.
Very focused, and look at this coach as well, being very careful not to interfere. This is an important moment for the coach. Lay back from the gymnast. The pressure's on him, don't add to it.
Offord, sitting fifth at 14.05 on P-bars. Still looks worried. He feels the moment, I think, this Sam.
It's a thriller. We're set up for a thriller here.
What pressure going into the high bar for Folwell. He's got a juicy lead, I think, and it's his to win or lose.
And high bar can do that. you've only got to dismount too early. That's what we say when a release goes wrong. Ooh, you dismounted too early. So, and that's all between him and the gold.
And Beckford, 13.5 on P-bar, so that's an unfortunate incident with a dismount has hurt him. But where is he now? He's sitting second behind Folwell, who's got a 1.15 lead over Beckford. Then it's Josh Jefferis, who's moved up to third. He'll need a lot to go right for him and a bit to go wrong for those in front of him to challenge for gold. And there's Whitlock, so it's England, Australia. And Misha Koudinov in seventh position for New Zealand.
and they don't have to prepare the apparatus. So they don't have to prepare the apparatus much between athletes on the high bar. It shouldn't take too long.
True to their form in qualifying, the top six from Monday are the top six into the last rotation. And here is Thomas Pichler. It looks to be between Australia and England. With Folwell holding the lead, Pickler's got to make this good.
Lovely, clean combination to start with. Big release is important. He's made the Kovac and beautifully swinging from it. Now then. That's good. Full twist in the straight somersault to catch. Oh, and he's lost his rhythm. You see, that is so important. On bar, you've got to keep the swing going. Squat dislow out a little bit flat there. Full turn from the endo swing. That's the straddle swing. After a little bit late catching, so he's got to do something with this. Big wind up, full twisting, double straight, playing a little bit safe on the dismount, but he had some problems there.
Yeah, a big problem in the middle of the routine for Pichler, and well, I guess we can sort of rule him out as a medalist because he can't bank on the other five.
Let me tell you something. Oh, that was lovely. Straight front with full turn to catch. There's no guarantee that everyone else isn't going to do that. That's the thrill of high bar. So he's done his job. One real bad error.
Carlos Krasias on rings.
Slightly high in the top plunge, and he's quite a slight gymnast. The strength will come, of course. He's a youngster still. Double tuck, double pike, good combination. It's a favoured combination amongst these gymnasts. Steady in the handstand. Good long swing to handstand. And full twist in the double tuck. Young man with a bit of a future.
Oh, absolutely, at 16. 13.05 on rings for him. And his work is done. Waiting for the score for Pichler, a 12.7. Temporarily in first position. Did you want to have a little sixpence on the side about whether he gets a medal or not?
I'm not risking sixpence.
Not with me. Because if you win, you'll never get it.
Well, What now?
Well, it's Max Whitlock.
Scott Hand, a little nervous. Gesture from the coach. This is so important for Max. Made the ginger release, and it was clean, and it's swinging well. And he has that plastic quality about his swinging. He does look good on the apparatus. He's got a measured approach all the way through. Nice working twister. Nice full turn there. The Healy. And another. From a different combination. Ooh, hang on to that pike a little bit too long on the squat distler. But these are minor errors. Big dismount coming up. And he absolutely nailed it. If ever you want to produce a landing, look at that bench. If you ever want to produce a landing, allow yourself a smile, young man, because that was pressure and you cope with it. And they are getting it to catch. Nicely done.
He is a wise head on very young shoulders.
Watch this now. Twist, twist, stick. Excellent.
Did not move a toe on that dismount.
Well, that really has put the cat amongst the pigeons.
And I saw the reaction from his teammates, a spontaneous admiration. Across to Honeyball on rings. This is his best apparatus. Let's hope he puts in a good one to finish off.
Yeah, you can tell it. He's got that powerful upper body build. And that's a lovely seated cross. Squeezes up in a Maltese. Oh, look at that, and swings to inverted cross. And another strength part. This really is very impressive to see. But he's got to inject a little bit of swing. Can he make the handstands to go with it? Now he's got to swing all the way from handstand to handstand in the end. Ooh. Well done. There's a big wind-up. Here comes the dismount. Straight in the first, piked in the second.
There's the African national champion on rings, Robert Honeyball. Well done to him. And a 13.85 for Max Whitlock, so he assumes the lead. Four gymnasts to come on high bar.
What a thriller.
Sam Offord, can he put his name up there? Or is he coming from too far back?
Very interesting technique there on the Yamawaki, and I don't think they'll give that a Yamawaki. Needed to be more stooped across the bar, but he's swinging well all the same. Good technique on the squat dislow. Smacks it out to handstand. Lovely inverted grass swinging here. There's a release. He's off. Full twist in the double straight. And he nailed it too. So that was a really strong routine from him.
What a leaf out of Max Whitlock's book with the perfect dismount.
He'd be a little bit down on difficulty. I'm not sure about that start, whether they'll give it the D that he wants. But that's a detail. He went through the routine.
Now, Koudinov of New Zealand. A chance to perhaps force his way into the top three if he can give us a perfect floor.
Well, he's made a good start, a good twisting start. Very, very well prepared gymnast. White. Good all-rounder, light of touch, sure of technique, good all-round prospect for New Zealand. They've done such a good job. Two and a half twist and half twist in the front somersault. A little breather, big tumble now. Can he nail it? Whip over. 1 3/4. Just one more tumble to go, making sure of it. Taking a deep breath. Look at that. twists all the way around.
And 83.0 is his total. 20th in the all-around 4 years ago. He's going to have a higher finish than that. Koudinov. Sam Offord, 14.0. And he can't win it. But this man can. Folwell. If he can nail this routine, the gold will be round his neck.
And I'll tell you what, if he goes through, his teammates will be delighted, because this is a real team man. Good, safe start. No release yet. Got to get that release in, and he's got to catch it. Here it comes. He's caught it, and he's swinging through it. And here's another one. He's not holding back. Two releases. Now, Mr. Folwell, you're doing this in style. You have not compromised your routine. Just keep swinging. Here comes the dismount. Stand it up. Double twist in the double straight, and that is good enough.
There's your man. That should be enough. And look, Folwell, the relief and the joy simultaneously. It's fantastic to see.
Kept himself under control, hasn't he, all the way through. What? Now, have a cry, boy. Go on.
What pressure on him, knowing it was his to win.
Oh, terrific for him. Great for his coach, Paul Hall. He's been there. He's produced Olympic medalists, world medalists, and now a Commonwealth gold medalist, provided someone doesn't score 17, and that's not going to happen. Well, this is excellent work. He really didn't hold back. Two releases, selects the shapes beautifully, smacks in the double twist, and look. He's been waiting for six operators to give that release in emotion. Look at it.
Well, his landing wasn't perfect, but the prize will be.
Wow, Mr. Folwell.
And as an all-around champion, Mitch, you must have gained such enormous respect from your peers.
Oh, yeah. And he especially. He's very popular. He's a serious young man, fantastic gymnast in a great club. He's worked so hard for this. Terrific.
So, Folwell must receive a score that will surely put him to the top of the leaderboard, and there he should stay. I don't think we're getting ahead of ourselves, are we, Mitchell?
I don't think so. I mean, if someone does the sums, we might be able to work out what the rest of the guys need, but it's going to be a colossal ask. He was a markup coming in. So, you know.
A little bit of pressure on the judges now to get it right.
Well, if you put a mark and a half or even two marks on top of this score, that will be the difference, and that's what someone will have to get.
Max Whitlock just at the moment is sitting in the gold medal position, but that's without the score of Folwell being thrown in. And Folwell punches, I think he's seen it on the big screen, and there it is, a 13.25 and 85.55 for first position. Reiss Beckford and Josh Jefferis still to come.
Big routine for him, this. After over-pitching the double pike, he can't afford... That's a good release. So, he satisfied that requirement. Here comes another. This is big. Kovac. He's off. Beautifully swung. So that was a terrific start from him. Two releases. And here's another one. And he's on with that one as well. Close into the bar now. He's settled down with good technical accuracy. Full turn. Endo swing, another full turn. That's the little hop and a half turn. This is the dismount. If you stand it up, the roof will come off. Yes, and it's brilliant. Yes, he said. Double twisting, double straight. Look at him applauding that. What a terrific finish from him. Put the disappointment. And look at this moment.
Well, you could get 1-2-3 here for England because Beckford was 1.15 behind Folwell coming in to the last apparatus. He's really thrown down the challenge here. This could be close.
Well, that was a terrific routine. And, yep, it could be a 1-2-3, but I think they're more interested in the fact that this young man, Beckford, has recovered from Peebles. He's shown a maturity.
Only Josh Jefferis of Australia can upset the clean sweep. Well, it's been Australia's day in team competition, 2 days really, with women's and men's, but it's England's turn now for sure. Beckford waiting the score, and 14.3 and 85.45. He's just a tenth behind Folwell, and Folwell surely is there, and it looks like gold and silver and perhaps bronze as well. Jefferis, last man up on high bar.
Well, if he gets a high 14, the cat could be among the pigeons, so look for that. You can break that stranglehold from England. That's a good start. And bent his arms there. You see, they won't. They'll see that. But it's a minor fault. Nicely out from the squad, Disner. Full turn. And he's working in twisted grass now. So this is good work. The difficulty will come up the grade. Now then. He'll wind it up, change of shape, big release, double twisting, double straight, little hop forward. But he needs a colossal mark to get in amongst those medals.
I think we're going to have a new all-around champion, Josh Jefferis, your man there, won it 4 years ago, but the baton has surely been passed to England.
If he gets a mark in the 14s, he will just scrape past Whitlock. Bronze.
Got to admire the way they've performed under pressure, this group on high bar, with it all on the line and some perfect dismounts, exciting routines. They've delivered when the pressure's been on. Is it 1-2-3? I wonder. Folwell and Beckford ought to be safe in gold and silver.
Oh, Josh Jefferis, he showed his all-round mettle there, right to the last. He was determined to try and creep into that bronze position. But anything in the 13s is no good to him. Oh, Max Whitlock, he did a great job. After his best piece, Pommel Horse, came adrift. Beckford had his problems too on P-bars, and he's come back with a bang on his last apparatus. Oh, they're looking hard. They don't want a clean sweep for England. What a champion he is. He's a great guy. Looking forward.
England qualified second, third and fifth with Beckford, Folwell and Whitlock. But it looks like it's Folwell who's going to claim the gold. Beckford threw everything at him with his high bar routine. Close to within a tenth. And Jefferis. It's going up on the screen that Jefferis could have got the bronze ahead of Whitlock.
Well, they're celebrating.
He's got the third with a 13.95 and 84.75. So he's just tipped a young Max Whitlock out of a bronze medal and prevented the England sweep. But gold and silver to Folwell and Beckford of England. And Josh Jefferis, gold 4 years ago. It's bronze today in the all-around. And what's been a wonderful competition.
Fabulous. And I've got to congratulate Jefferis, really, because he hasn't had the best day. And he had to produce that to stop the clean sweep. He did that. Great work. But for Luke Folwell, fabulous, fabulous day for him. He's such a hard-working gymnast. Beckford came back from problems on P-bars. He got in there for silver, just a tenth behind. Yeah, but he's disappointed. Look, really, he did a job, but bronze when you've taken gold.
One and two. There are your boys. Look, Folwell, Reiss Beckford.
Yeah. That's great stuff.
Confirming the standings, it's Luke Folwell, 85.55 from Reiss Beckford, England 1 and 2. Josh Jefferis, terrific effort from him too to claim the bronze, 84.75. Then Max Whitlock and now the two Australians, beg your pardon, Sam Offord in fifth and Misha Koudinov. Wonderful finish for the New Zealander to come in sixth position. And Patrick Peng, fellow Kiwi, in 13th. But it's been a great all-around. Robert Honeyball, 22nd position for the boy we've been following from Namibia. He's had a good day as well. Medal presentation won't be far away.
Well, they'll be soaking this up now. Look at that, slap my hand. And he's done a great, great job. Yeah. And aren't they pleased?
and gentlemen, the medal ceremony for the men's individual all-around final.
Devi aur Sajjano, Purush Ekal All-Round Final ke Padak Vitaran Samaroh mein aap sabhi ka swagat hai.
Led in by, was that loose from the Indian Army? The athletes to claim gold, silver and bronze men's all-around competition at the 19th Commonwealth Games. What a competition it's been. The glorious unpredictability of sport, we sometimes say, Mitchell, we had it here in spades in the men's all-around.
Yeah, it was terrific, and it went down to the wire. That's, I know it's a cliche, but that's exactly what it did. And the guys on high bar really had to show mental security, mental strength. Fabulous. And little Josh Jefferis to come in after not the best day and to squeeze a bronze. That was an achievement, but England, well, what a day for them.
I think what will give them all a great deal of pleasure is to know that in the last rotation, the final apparatus, nobody let themselves down.
No, and all the pressure on one of the riskiest apparatus of all. And then, as I say, they showed mental strength. And what a delightful day for Luke Folwell. Incredible, at last.
Josh Jefferis came in as the defending champion. In fact, he was the only medal winner from 2006 to be in the all-around final. And he's got a bronze medal to go with his gold from 4 years ago. He does still look just that little bit disappointed, but he needn't be. He gave a great competition. It was great to see Reiss Beckford sharing in the joy of the 1-2 finish rather than dwelling on the disappointment of his P-bar's dismount with take that back and he might have had the gold, but he's still a happy man.
So he should be. Still a young man. Brilliant in the junior ranks and now broken into the senior ranks. What a prospect.
Be. A mighty big smile he gave us, Mitch.
He'll store this one away forever. Terrific. Popular young man. Serious. Great moment. He's waited a long, long time.
Highlight of his gymnastics career.
Indeed. He comes from a fabulous club. They've taken Olympic bronze, world silver, and now here he is, Commonwealth gold.
Ladies and gentlemen, the national anthem of England.
Devi aur Sajjano, Swarn Padak Vijeta, England ki Rashtra.
Tariq Folwell, able to drink it all in and never forget it. He is your all-around champion for the Commonwealth Games of Delhi. Alongside Reiss Beckford, the silver, and Josh Jefferis of Australia, the bronze. So England 1 and 2, Australia 3rd. Hope you've enjoyed that competition.